In this video, we're going to write the script for our enemies. In our scripts folder, we're going to go to Create, C# Script, and we'll call it Enemy. Let's open it up in MonoDevelop. The first thing that we're going to do in our Enemy class is to set it to inherit from our Moving Object class. You'll remember we wrote Moving Object in a previous video. By causing Enemy to inherit from Moving Object, it means that we can have it take advantage of the movement code that we wrote there without having to duplicate that functionality within the Enemy class. Next, we're going to declare some variables. We're going to start with a public integer called player damage. This is the number of food points that are going to be subtracted when the enemy attacks the player. We're also going to declare some private variables, starting with a private variable of the type animator called animator. We're also going to declare a private variable of the type transform called target, which we're going to use to store the player's position and tell the enemy where to move towards. We're also going to have a private boolean called skipMove, which we're going to use to cause the enemy to move every other turn. We're going to change our start function to a protected override function because we're going to override the start function in our base class MovingObject. The first thing we're going to do in our start function is we're going to get and store a component reference to our animator. We're going to use GameObject.findGameObjectWithTag to store the transform of the player in our target variable. Finally, we're going to call the start function in our base class MovingObject. Enemy is also going to have its own implementation of attemptMove, and so we're going to declare attemptMove again as a protected override function that returns void. As before, attemptMove takes a generic parameter t. In this case, we're going to pass in the player component because that's what we expect the enemy to be interacting with. The first thing that we're going to do inside attemptMove is to check if skipMove is true. So to see if this turn the enemy should be skipping a turn, if so, we're going to set skipMove to false and return. This is what we're going to use to cause our enemy to only move every other turn. Next, we're going to call the attemptMove function from MovingObject. When calling attemptMove, we're going to pass in our generic parameter t, which in this case will be the player, along with the parameters for the x direction and y direction to move in. Now that the enemy is moved, we're going to set skipMove to true. The next thing that we're going to do is declare a public function that returns void called moveEnemy. This is going to be called by the game manager when it issues the order to move to each of our enemies in our enemies list. In moveEnemy, we're going to declare a couple of integer variables, x direction and y direction, and initialize those to zero. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to check the position of target against the current position of our transform and figure out which direction to move in. What we're going to do is we're going to check if the difference between the x-coordinate of target's position and the x-coordinate of transform's position is less than epsilon in this case, which we're using to represent a number close to zero. So basically, we're checking to see, are the x-coordinates roughly the same, meaning our enemy and our player are in the same column. If they are in the same column, we're going to check if the y-coordinate of our target's position is greater than the y-coordinate of our transform position. If so, we're going to move up, meaning move towards the player, and if not, we're going to move down to move towards the player. So in this case, if our condition evaluates to true, we're going to use positive 1, meaning we're going to move up. Otherwise, we're going to use negative 1, meaning we're going to move down. If our first conditional check to check if we're in the same column evaluates to false, we're going to move along the horizontal axis. To do this, we're going to set x direction based on if target's position.x is greater than our transform position x, we're going to move to the right using 1, a positive value. Otherwise, we're going to move to the left using negative 1. With that done, we're going to call attemptMove, passing in player as the generic parameter, and passing in our x direction and our y direction to move in. The last thing that we're going to do is we're going to write our onCan'tMove function. On-camp move is called if the enemy attempts to move into a space occupied by the player. It overrides the on-camp move function of moving object, which you'll remember we implemented as abstract. It takes a generic parameter t, which we use to pass in the component we expect to encounter, which in this case is a player. On-camp move takes a parameter of the type t called component. The first thing that we're going to do in on-camp move is declare a variable of the type player called hit player, and we're going to set that to equal the component that we passed in, which we're going to cast to a player. Next, we're going to call the lose food function from player, passing in player damage, which is going to be the loss parameter for lose food, and specify how many food points to subtract from the player's total based on this enemy's attack. Let's clean up our script a bit by deleting the update function and the comment for start. Now that we've got our enemy script written, in the next video, we're going to make some additions to the game manager so that it can manage the enemies, and we're also going to set up our enemy animator controller.